Hi! Today we will learn about polar patterns and how you can use them to improve your recordings. When I used to go to audio engineering school, polar patterns were one of my favorite topics. I love polar patterns. And over the last couple of years in my profession, I've been able to constantly improve my recordings because I really took the time to understand what they mean. So, what actually is a polar pattern? As you might know, a microphone transforms an incoming sound wave into an electrical signal. Now, the polar pattern tells you where the microphone is most sensitive to those incoming sound waves. Spoiler alert! Most microphones will work best when you point them directly towards their source. Let's take a look at the polar graph of the most common polar pattern for recording microphones, the cardioid pattern. The polar graph describes the field in which the microphone is the most sensitive to picking up sound. You can find polar graphs in the spec sheets of your stage or recording microphones, or on the website of the manufacturer. The cool thing is that the polar graph tells you the relative sensitivity. Sound hitting your mic from here will have 20 dB less compared to sound hitting the capsule from the front. The cardioid pattern got its name from its heart-like shape. Why? Because polar patterns are love. The cardioid is great for getting a dry signal. It helps to minimize the effect of a bad sounding room. It helps to blend out noisy sounds from the background like a fan or other sources that might be behind the microphone. And the cardioid pattern is the most common choice for vocal and instrument recordings on stage, at home, and in the studio. As you can hear, it's the most sensitive from the front. It's less sensitive at the sides. And it's the least sensitive from the back. By getting closer to the mic, we can experience a bass boost, which is what we call the proximity effect. Proximity. Nerd fact! Mathematically, the cardioid pattern is a rolling circle on a circle with the same radius. Mind-blowing. Of course, there are more polar patterns. Let's take a look at the ones that I personally consider to be the most important. Do you have a favorite polar pattern? Please let us know in the comments below. Next up, the supercardioid polar pattern. The supercardioid pattern is even more focused on your source than the cardioid pattern. It has a bit more side rejection, but a bit less rear rejection. In my opinion, it isn't as useful for home recording purposes as the cardioid pattern because you're probably less likely to have disturbing sounds coming from the sides when you're recording at home. But if that's the case, well, there you go. You have it, you can use it if you want. I mainly use mics with the supercardioid pattern to record the toms on a drum kit, or sometimes I'll stick them in front of guitar cabinets for live shows. How would you use a supercardioid pattern? Let us know in the comments. This next one is easy to remember because it looks like an 8. The figure 8 polar pattern has the same sensitivity at the front of the microphone as it does at the back of the microphone. It also has the best side rejection of all of the polar patterns. Figure 8 mics are often used for stereo recording techniques like mid-side and blumline. Compared to all of the other polar patterns, it has the weakest bass response, and it's the most sensitive to wind and handling noise. The last one we're going to have a look at is the Omni pattern. As you can hear, mics with an Omni pattern record sound waves from all directions. All directions. They don't have the proximity effect either, so you can get real close without a bass boost. They're great in the studio and will shine in good sounding rooms. An Omni pattern provides you with a really natural bass response, and it has the flattest frequency response of all of the polar patterns. They're also less sensitive to handling wind noise and handling noise and handling noise and handling noise. They're also the least sensitive to handling or wind noise in comparison to all the other patterns. So, here's a personal story. My first microphone was a 7th order ambisonics microphone that I made out of cat food tins. The end. If there are any open questions, please let us know in the comments section. Let us know what you want us to cover in the future. And if you liked the video, don't forget to subscribe and hit the like button. Make yourself heard.